appreciate it, bro.
Rookie all over again. You know, from the day one when you got here, I feel like you and I have always gotten along. Like, it was supernatural, even while we were competing for the same job. Why do you think it worked the way it did?
I think the biggest thing was how you kind of accepted me into the quarterback room. Obviously, coming in, being a first-round draft pick, you could have treated it many different ways. But you kind of just went in and you were like, you were so sure of yourself. You were like, I'm going to go in, I'm going to play my best football, and whatever happens, happens. So whenever I got in the quarterback room and saw how professional you were, I knew that I had to just continue to get better and get better. You talked about your experiences when you were early in your career and how you learned different things, and you'd give me those tips so that I wouldn't have to learn them on the go like you did. And so I think just that and the type of guy that you were, I think that just really helped me go out there and just really just become a part of the team.
Okay, so we're going to touch this on the Super Bowl. I read that you had said it was, I think, your worst, was that like worst loss of your career?
Yeah.
What were some of the takeaways looking back at that loss?
I feel like as a whole team, really, especially as offense, we started pressing. We started trying to do stuff that we had never done before. Instead of going back to our fundamentals and going back to stuff that got us there. That started with me. We had a lot of RPOs. There was some I was pulling even though the read wasn't there. So I think when I look back at it now, it's just how can I get us to not do that?
Arguably, your biggest offseason acquisition, Sterling.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, you're a dad. What has that been like and fatherhood for you here this year?
I think the biggest thing it's done for me is put things in perspective of just me being able to go home after practice or go home from training camp and see her. It kind of gives me that perspective of there's a lot more than just football. To be able to have her, Brittany's been amazing as a mom, a first-time mom of taking stuff off my plate so I can still be who I am, but at the same time letting me enjoy those moments that you have as a girl dad.
So I don't know if you know this, you could be the fourth QB in history to go to 3 consecutive Super Bowls. Did you know that?
I did not know that. I know it's they're hard to make.
Can you name the 3 QBs?
Jim Kelly's got to be one of them.
Boom, one.
Is Tom on there?
Tom is on there too. Let's see if you can help 3. Those are the 2 I got. I didn't get the third.
Third, Bart Starr.
It's a good guess. So it's Greasy with the Dolphins. So it's okay. The only 3 teams, 3 quarterbacks that have done it. I think the bigger question is exactly that. What would it mean for you to go back there again?
Yeah, I think it would just show that we haven't wasted the greatness that we have in this locker room. The culture that's been built here, Coach Reed, the way he's able to coach, and then to be able to go out there and just execute week in and week out. It takes a special group of guys. The biggest thing would just be able to say that you're part of that group of a lot of great quarterbacks.
I think for me, watching from afar, you're doing stuff on a football field that I think is unprecedented, but I think the person that you have remained off the field is so unique. You're so special. It's been fun, man. I'm such a big fan. I'm always, you know, obviously love you, bro, and always pulling for you, but excited for you.
Appreciate you, man.
It's been awesome.